King of Kings, to your deliverer, to your helper, to the one that we have waited upon, the one that can rescue us from every pit of darkness, the one that can deliver us from every kind of darkness. Blessed be your name. Wave unto him. Glory be to your name. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are giving thanks and we. God said, I can tell somebody, I am here to rescue you. I don't know what thing that you, what predicament you are in, that you need divine rescuing. You are going to open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, in this service, rescue me from every unpleasant pit that I have found myself. Pit, financial pit, satanic pit, health pit. Rescue me! Marital pit, career pit, academic pit. Rescue me! In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. God will make you stronger than your enemy. I'm going to pray one prayer that David prayed once upon a time. He said that, let not my enemy triumph over me. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, help me, fight for me, and let none of my enemies triumph over me. Make it impossible for the enemies to triumph over me. Let not my enemies triumph over me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Who is he that says a thing and it comes to pass when the Lord has not said it? Anything that has been said against you, against your destiny, against your family, that could be affecting any member of your family or affecting you, today, let there be divine consolation. Let there be divine consolation. Let there be divine consolation. Open your mouth and pray, say, Father, every satanic utterance, every satanic incantation, every satanic word, every negative word that has been spoken against me, against my family, against my destiny, that is affecting me, cancel. Every satanic word, incantation, suggestion, report, opinion that is not yours, cancel. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Many times God is waiting on us. We will be saying we are waiting on God. We are waiting on God. Sometimes He's waiting on you. When you are giving a child something to do something, take money, take 1,000 naira. I am hungry. I am giving you all you need to quench your hunger. Go and buy something now. I am hungry. Many believers are like that. In the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 10, he was telling Jeremiah, he said that I have ordained you, I have equipped you as a child of God to root up, to destroy, to pull down. Stop waiting for me. Do it. What I have told you that you can do. See, I have this day sent thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plan. It's in your hand. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every satanic plantation manifesting in my life, in my home, in my family, I command by the power of the Most High God, be uprooted and destroyed. Be uprooted. I have the power. I've got the power. Rakashakara, be uprooted and destroyed. Be uprooted and destroyed. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Brethren, we have the power, the superior power. In the book of Luke chapter 10, verse 19, Bible says, behold, I give unto you what? Power over the power of the enemy. And you can, but the thing is that before already, because they don't know what they already have. Behold! It's as if they are telling you, see inside of you. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall by any means what? It is when you don't use your power that those things will hurt you. If you refuse to use your power, don't see a serpent coming, and you have something that has been created that you can from a distance just flee on it, and you just die. If you don't use it, it mentally come, and you now tell that this thing normally kill human being, but it is the one that does not use that thing against it. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every satanic oppression in anywhere in my life, today, I decree a stop to it. Stop. In the name of Jesus, I decree by the superior power, every satanic oppression anywhere in my life, I command in the name of Jesus, stop. Cease from operating. Cease from operating. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Say, Father, anything I've lost to carelessness, anything that I've lost to foolishness, anything that I've lost to sin, in your mercy, help me to recover every good thing that I've lost to carelessness, foolishness, lost to deceit of darkness, lost to satanic manifestation. Father, in your mercy, help me to recover all. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. We wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. We wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. We wait. For your power, for your deliverance, we wait on you. There, Father, reach out to your power. Your power has no limitation. There is no time that is a limitation to your power. Any time that the word is coming forth, whether recorded or live, it is equally potent. Release your power. Deliver us in the area that we need deliverance. Heal us in the area that we need healing. Help us anywhere we need help. At the end of the day, let the summary of this service be that God has manifested, so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we are worship and we are also praying. Let somebody shout the Lord. God bless you, receive them. Dealing with the power behind it in the dream. Strange topic. Dealing with the power behind what? Eating in the dream. When you read the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11:29-30, 1 Corinthians 11:29-30, we normally read this during Holy Communion service, but it is a scripture that could be underutilized You know, one thing about the scripture of God, the word of God, is that it is multifaceted. Meaning that any direction you turn into, it will hit it and it will make good what it has sent to it. But let me just read this one first. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, I'm just trying to tell you that there can be a kind of food or eating that may be unworthy. Eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause, many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. Oh my God, may God give you deep revelation beyond the surface. This scripture is good, we use this for Holy Communion, but it's very much pregnant, more pregnant than it is. I tell you that the word of God is multifaceted. In the book of Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, Hebrews 4, 12, you realize it's a double-edged sword, meaning that if you swing this way, it will cut. If you swing this way, it will cut. The part of this scripture is telling you that many eat and drink some things, but they are not worthy to be eaten or drunk. And by their eating of it, some of them are weak. Some of them are sick. Some of them self, they sleep. When you sleep, you are not sensitive. Eating in the dream. Behold, I present to you what it does in the scripture. In that 1 Corinthians chapter 11, 29 and 30. It's not just only for me. The word of God is so vast. Many people eat in the dream and it has been affecting many of us. An end has come to that nonsense. Yeah. I said, an end has come to that nonsense. Yeah. There are some, some people are eating and they are weak, meaning that they are supposed to be spiritually strong. I don't feel like praying. I don't feel like coming. Ah! Sorry, have you been eating the dream? I thought that they just eating in the dream. No! I saw one movie. And that movie, some time ago, and at the beginning of the movie, they just showed one guy. You know, he's one of my funny guys in a Yoruba movie. We don't know the guy. He has my guy. I forgot what is it called. You know, one funny guy like this. He used to. I don't know what he called it. Sonyeri. He was just at the beginning of the movie. He was just. There was a table set before him. He was closing his eyes. He was not eating. See a funny look. See one plate, different assorted meat, then pounded yam. But the funny thing in that particular, well, they didn't show that it was a dream. It was when I started watching it, I saw that it was a dream. That table was at a T-junction. Was it crossroad or T-junction on the road? But it was set with correct food. And he kept on eating. He was really like eating. And surrounding him were three women dressed in black and red. You know, just papa, black and red. You know those people. Now? You know them, captain. This we call them captain. Captain, they can. So, one of my own pastor, when he's speaking in our church, man. Father's church, he said that the captains. I didn't know that he meant that the people that used to fly. So three of them, they just stood around him and was eating. They don't know in their head. After he finished eating, he now took toothpick. But not doing like this. That was how he now woke up. They now showed that it was a dream. But in real life, he now had toothpick. In real life, he was doing like this. He now woke up. He now went to one spiritualist. He said, the dream, you're in trouble. I won't tell you what happened in the book. But actually, they used that because they're a bit spiritual on the other side to tell you that kind of thing can affect a person? He said that you eat in the dream and you are weak. Some people, they can eat and they have in the dream. I don't know the one that they have presented to you before. I won't tell you the one we have eaten before. Some people is fried rice. They say, ah. Some people is a parasite. Some people is something that is not correct. Biscuit. Whatever it is that the enemy has sent us. You know one thing about the scripture is so correct and complete. In the book of Matthew chapter 13, 24 to 28, Matthew 13, 24 to 28, said that, why men slept? What do you think that we are talking about? Why men slept? The enemy came and sow. Who was he sowing as a farmer? Sowing care, sowing sickness, sowing disappointment, sowing discouragement, sowing depression, sowing the thing that will not manifest in the person. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every satanic dream that affect me with any negative thing, let there be divine reversal. Reverse that dream. Reverse the effect. Reverse the effect. Raka shaka. Yeke bebe. Let it be reversed. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let there be divine reversal of any negative effect of anything in your life. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. God bless you. Things that people eat have brought so many problems to different people. After you said that, there are some things that you can eat that they are good. But there are some unworthy things. There are some people eat some things unworthily and it leads to their weakness. It leads to sickness. It leads to some are sickly. Then it leads to some people sleeping. Sleeping in two versions. Some people, they are not dead, but they are not sensitive anymore. They die here. When you are sleeping, when somebody enters, you don't know. And the other spiritual aspect is that some people sleep and die. Food. You know what happened to Esau? It was food. Food that made him to lose his firstborn right. Food. And I'll take you to the scripture of this thing of eating, that you don't start seeing with your spiritual eyes beyond your normal eating the dream. It was food that made Adam and Eve what they ate. In Genesis 2:17. God told them that there are some things, you can eat many things, but there are some things that they are not supposed to be eating. Once you eat it, you will lose your throne. You will lose something negative will happen. But on the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die. And you know what happens to them? Food. In Genesis 25, 34, so Genesis 25, 34, Esau, he said, I am weak, I am fainting, I'm almost dying. Give me porridge. It was pottage that made some people have eaten the dream. And the appointment that they were so sure it was their own, they missed Esau. Relationship that was so sure, Esau. They didn't think or connect it to eating in the dream. But the people on the other side of the world, the dark people, they know they can actually come with that and exchange people's destiny. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father! Say, Father! Anything that has been presented to me in the dream that is still affecting me, show me your mercy and counsel it out of my life and destiny. Counsel out of my life and destiny. Raka shaka. Make a kuma. Counsel out of my life and destiny. I will not miss my appointed time. I will not miss my glorious visitation. He missed it because of food. What he ate. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Recover what you have lost to it in the dream.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Eating in the dream can cause, there was a particular guy that anytime he had a dream of drinking palm wine in the dream, any appointment he had next would just go bad. And he had been having that kind of repeated negative trend or cycle. Anytime he was going for a particular appointment, he was so sure that it was going to be given unto him that job. Overnight, he had the dream of that drinking party. He woke up, he was already sad because he had already seen the track record of how this thing. Some of us, when we have a dream of a particular thing, there will be a manifestation. But from today, you are having victory.
Yeah.
I said you are having victory.
Yeah.
Rachel, it was dream that caused her to miss her appointed time of fruitfulness at a particular time. Food. Genesis 30, 14 to 17, you see there, if you're interested. You see there, he was being cared of what living that she wanted to eat. And she now, the sister was saying that, I'm the one, even though you are the one that is supposed to sleep, give me this spoon, let me eat it, and take my place. That day, there was visitation on whoever who sleep with the husband. She missed it. Just food. You can even try and eat it. And women went in the days of wheat harvest and found mandrakes in the field and brought them unto his mother, Leah. And Rachel, you know, she had been trusting God. And that one had been having children. Said to Leah, give me, I pray thee, of thy son's mandrakes. And she said unto her, is it a small matter that thou hast taken my husband? And wouldst thou take away my son's mandrake also? And Rachel said, therefore he shall lie with thee tonight. And that was the night of visitation, she missed it. Tonight, for thy son's mandrake and exchange. And Jacob came out of the field in the evening. And Leah went out to meet him and said, thou must come in unto me, for surely I have hired thee with my son's mandrake. And he lay with her that night. What happened? God already determined that this is because it was richest night, richest time. But someone said that, give me this for you, use this by time, I will use another time. And God hearkened unto Leah, and she conceived and bare Jacob the fifth son. Many of us, eating in the dream, has made us to lose the right position. The time you are supposed to do something that will bring results, that time, because of that eating in the dream, you will not feel like, I don't feel like that time. The time you feel like nothing was supposed to happen at that time. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every negative effect of missed opportunities, missed appointment, and delivered by the reason of it in the dream. Reverse it, cancel it in my life. Cancel it in my life. Every effect of eating in the dream that has led to me not being at the right place at the right time, not being doing the right thing at the right time to receive the best result, I let it be canceled. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Every eating in the dream that has led to so many disappointments, so many missed positioning in your life, today it is reversed. That you have missed, I don't know how long you have missed it, whether some days ago, some months ago, years ago, decades ago. Let all of them be proper.
Amen.
Let all of them be proper.
Amen.
And let the and deliver it into your life. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. God bless you, well done. Some eat unworthily and drink unworthily, and they are weak. Some eat and drink unworthily, and they are sickly. Many growth in people's body. God asks the people, have you been eating in the dream? Fibroid. Even cancer. Things that the enemy, one man slept, they planted something. It's not everything that grew on their own accord. Every growth is not us equal to early growth. There are some growths that we have been told that they are satanic plantation. One man slept, the enemy came and sowed. And whatever it is, sown will develop over time. And really, I'm feeling something. Something is burning up. Something, every of those things in your body shall melt away. Yeah. Open your mouth and pray, Father, send down your fire into my spirit, soul, and body, and melt out of me every strange growth, every strange thing that dream has brought into my life, anything in my system, anything bringing pain, bringing discomfort to me, flush it out by fire. Bless them, your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Every satanic plantation, through eating in a dream, or any satanic visitation in your sleep, let the blood of Jesus Christ flush out. Let the blood of Jesus flush out. Let the blood of Jesus flush out. In the name of Jesus. That pain that is not of God disappear. That growth, not fibroid or any other name, cancer, TU that is out of place, disappear. In the name of Jesus. God bless you. Please be seated. We'll still be praying because our same prayer point that we're going to be praying. So the technical will be featuring all. But there's another eating in the dream that can be good. Or eating that can be good, spiritual eating. It doesn't have to be in the dream per se. But God can come to you through his angel like Elijah. Eat and drink, for the journey is far. And that eating will bring strength. One is bringing weakness. The one that is coming from who is bringing weakness. From who is bringing with them? Anyone that is coming from God is bringing strength. In the book of 1 Kings chapter 19, if you read 7 and 8, the Bible says that he had the second time, the word of God is the food. As I'm releasing powerful pronouncement here, is the food is entering into your spirit. And it is bringing strength, uncommon, unusual strength into your life.
Amen.
And the angel of the Lord came again the second time and touched him and said, arise and eat, because the journey is too great for thee. Eat. And he arose and did eat and drink, and went in the strength of that meat 40 days and 40 nights into Oreb, the mount of God. Food of God is the word. He said that I am the bread of what? Of life. Anyone that eateth of me, anytime you are hearing the word of God, you are eating the food of God into your spirit. And it is diluting the effect of any negativity. You can pump so much of God's food into you. Just read it. Get audio Bible. Be sleeping, but let it be playing. Feed it. You'll be amazed. There are many things that God has programmed even with technology that can benefit us. But many of us may not even use it. Let the word be going into you. There are audio Bible. Get the app. Also download it. And plan that this particular night, I want the word of God to feed me. Be sleeping, or your spirit is not stable. Your body may sleep. Your spirit is entering. There are some things that will be coming to you on their own accord. And you want to know, I know this body because the word of God has entered. It is ever potent. I decree into your life. After this service, everything will turn out positive and glorious for you. Rise to your feet and pray and say, Father, thank you because my deliverance has come. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Whoever God chose this word for, because I did not plan it to, he just came this afternoon. This is what we are going to be ministering about. I don't know who. Thank you. Thank you. Prayer points. Thank you, God. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Dear Father, I thank you for this insight and time for the long-awaited deliverance of mine in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you in advance. For this insight, a long-awaited deliverance of mine. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying number two. Just go, just go, just go. Father, please have mercy on me. And forgive me of anything that will not make you to answer my prayers right now. Father, please have mercy on me and forgive me of anything that will not make you to answer my prayer right now. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Once I say in Jesus' mighty name, you are praying, just go to the next prayer point as the person used to do, whoever used to do it before. Say, Father, please keep me from eating any food that will open me up for satanic attacks. In the name of Jesus, Father, keep me from eating any food, whether physical or spiritual, that will open me up from every satanic attack. If it will happen, let something scatter you before I even get to that point. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please visit every satanic cook or caterer that have been presenting and feeding me with demonic food and drink in the name of Jesus. Visit every satanic cook or caterer that has been presenting and feeding me with demonic food or drink. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying, Father, please flush out of my body any trace of any satanic food or drink in my spirit, soul, and body. Flush out, flush out, flush out, flush out, flush out every trace of any satanic food or drink. At any point in time, any residue that is still there, flush it out. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Just wait until I say in Jesus' name before you change it. Say, Father, please destroy every satanic spell or programming yet towards me, missing any good appointment in the name of Jesus. Father, please destroy this satanic spell of programming. Yes, towards me, missing any good appointment. Some people, it is that time their phone will not be connected. If, oh now, this one is unreachable, and you want to give the person something, they will not call another person. Any spell of programming, yes, towards me, missing any good appointment. Destroy it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, please call the blood of Jesus to flow into my spirit, soul, and body. And flush out every satanic deposit, breathing in and drinking in the dream. Let the blood of Jesus flow into my spirit, soul, and body, and flush out every satanic deposit, through eating and drinking in the dream. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Once I say in Jesus' mighty name, don't wait, just do it so that I will just continue. Say, Father, in your mercy, please restore every good thing I have lost, which I need to fully rejoice and be at peace in the name of Jesus. In your mercy, please restore every good thing I have lost, which I need to fully rejoice and be at peace. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, please destroy every satanic programming. Check all costly mistakes in my life in the name of Jesus. Every satanic programming, check all costly mistakes. Me not be at the right place, or give me in like this or to something I should not give it to. Every satanic mistake that I've been programmed, destroy. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please keep costly mistake away from me. And all that have anything to do with me in the name of Jesus. Father, keep costly mistake away from me. And everything that has anything to do with me. Everything that I'm connected with, keep costly mistake away from. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please revive any manifestation of death in any area of my life by the reason of satanic feeding at any point in time in the name of Jesus. Father, reverse any manifestation of death, financial death, marital death, organ death. Any manifestation of death in any area of my life by the reason of satanic feeding at any point, reverse. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please cleanse me from any defilement resulting from any satanic food or drink I have ever taken, which is still working against my progress in the name of Jesus. Father, cleanse me from any satanic defilement resulting from any satanic food or drink I have ever taken, which is working against my progress. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please divinely remove anything within my system that is weakening me in any form, and renew my strength in the name of Jesus. Anything within my strength that I have been introduced that is weakening me, and renew my strength. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, I decree by the power of the Most High God that evil food in my body should come all the way out of their hiding places in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. 15 says, I command by the power in the blood of Jesus. Any food I have eaten on the table of the devil that I mingled with my blood be divinely flushed out now in the name of Jesus. Let every food I have eaten on the table of the devil be presented to me as a good, costly environment table, not knowing that it's a panic which is presenting that setup. Man Shakarama, that has mingled with my blood, polluting my blood, infecting my blood, affecting my blood. Father, flush out. Blood of Jesus, flush it out. Blood of Jesus, flush them out of my system. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I decree that every demonic or witchcraft food I am eating in the dream will be purged out of my body in the name of Jesus. Let every demonic or witchcraft food I have ever eaten in the name be pushed out. Pushed out. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying, Father. Please visit every witchcraft or evil night cook assigned to be feeding me in between with poisons and spiritual defilement with your consuming fire. Visit every witchcraft and every evil night cook or caterer that have been assigned to be feeding me in between with poison and spiritual defilement. Visit them with your consuming fire. Visit every satanic caterer, every satanic cook, every witchcraft power that have been assigned to be feeding me in between. Visit them with your consuming fire. In Jesus' mighty name, we are blessed, Father. Please let every satanic power spirit and soul for any satanic party or any satanic gathering for feeding, receive the fire of destruction wherever they are. Every satanic power that is summoning my spirit and soul to any satanic party or satanic gathering, in the dream it will be like a party, in the dream it will be like a normal business gathering. For any satanic party or gathering, for feeding, we see the fire of God. We see the fire of God. Unto destruction. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Romans 19 says, Father, please let the blood of Jesus flow through my spirit, soul, and body, and purge out every evil rubbish or pollution in my throat, in my stomach, in my organ, in my leg, in my womb, in my... Every baby blood of Jesus, flow and flush it out. Every evil rubbish, every evil pollution, blood of Jesus, flush it out of my system. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 20 out of 24, say, Father, please close every doorway or gateway in which evil spirit or power I've been using to assess my life, especially in my dream. Close it. Every doorway, every gateway in which evil spirit and evil power I've been using to assess me, my especially in my dream. Close that doorway. Close that gateway. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 21 says, by the power of the Most High God, I draw Jesus' bloodline around my life and my family in the name of Jesus. I draw it. They cannot go around that line. I draw the blood of Jesus around my life, my family, my property. I throw the blood of Jesus Christ around my life, around my family, around my home, around everything. That's the bloodline. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 23 says, I decree by the power of the Lord Savior that every sickness introduced into my life as a result of evil dream should disappear. With the immediate effect, every sickness, every disease.